डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई मिस्टर विशाल शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, कृष्णा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी कराड, वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेशन ऑन फार्मास्यूटिकल ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री 2. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कल्जन एंड मोफिट्स मॉडिफिकेशन एज वेल एज द सैक्सिमोहर थ्योरी दैट इज यूज टू एक्सप्लेन द स्टेबिलिटी एंड रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ साइक्लोअल्केन्स. In previous videos, we have discussed in detail about the Bayer strain theory, which gives us information related to the stability and reactivity of cycloalkanes. But as we know, Bayer was unable to explain certain things related to the higher cycloalkanes, as well as according to the Bayer, cyclopentane is more stable, but practically this is not true. Cyclohexane is considered as a more stable as compared to the cyclopentane. So these are the various limitations that are present in Bayer strain theory. These limitations can be overcome by this Kolgan-Moffitt theory as well as the Sachse-Mohr theory. So let's begin our today's talk. So first we will see the learning outcomes of this session. After this session, students will be able to explain Kolgan-Moffitt's modification as well as the Sachse-Mohr theory. So these are the two theories which gives us information related to the different aspects that are the limitations of the Bayer strain theory. Kolgan-Moffitt's theory will give us information why the cyclopropane is having Bentz bond, and Sachse-Mohr theory will give us information related to the stability of the cyclohexane. So one by one we will discuss these theories. Now first we will discuss about the Kolgan and Moffitt's modification. Actually this is not a theory, just he has explained how cyclopropane is able to achieve the bond angle of 60 degrees, and how overlapping of the p orbitals of the carbon atom is limited, which arose the concept of the bent bond. Now one of the first bent bond theories for cyclopropane was so called it's a Kolgan-Moffitt model, which he has proposed in 1947. Now in organic chemistry, a bent bond is also known as the banana bond, is a type of covalent chemical bond with geometry somewhat reminiscent to the banana, where there might be increase or decrease in the s character of that particular bond will take place. So such a types of bonds are known as the bent bond. In detail we will discuss what is the meaning of that bent bond. Now the term itself is a general representation of electron density or the configuration resembling similar to the bent structure with the small ring molecules. For example, we will consider cyclopropane or representation of a double or triple bonds within a compound that is alternative to the sigma and the pi bond model. So here just I have given one figure. If we consider this as a cyclopropane, in order to maintain the 60 degrees as a angle, what happens, whatever these p orbitals of this carbon atom and this carbon atom are there, they will come inward to get the maximum overlapping, and due to which somewhat these bonds are having a structure like a bent structure, and that's why these types of the bonds are known as the bent bond. Now we will see what is the bent bonds in the cyclopropane. Here just you can see this particular figure as I suggested. Here you can see this is the p orbital of this carbon atom, this is the p orbital of this carbon atom. If these both the carbon atoms maintain the tetrahedral angle, then it is not possible for these two orbitals to get overlapped. But in order to form a covalent bond, it is necessary that the overlapping of these two p orbitals is necessary. And to get the some amount of the overlapping, these particular two bonds are bent towards these particular carbon atoms, and due to which a small extent of overlapping is taking place. Now, in previous video also we have discussed what is the meaning of good overlapping as well as the what is the meaning of bad overlapping, where if the overlapping is not full, then that particular bond will not be stronger, and that's why whatever the covalent bonds that are present in the cyclopropane, they are not having that much amount of the strong overlapping, and that's why these bonds are also having the less strong covalent bond or weaker covalent bond. Now, in this case, what happens due to the bending of this particular p orbitals towards the carbon atom, this type of structure or the bond that is formed is known as the bent bond or banana like structure is formed, and that's why also bent bonds are known as the banana bonds. So cyclopropane and cyclobutane, they are having more amount of this particular bent bond, and due to which this structure is known as the cyclopropane with the banana bond. Now, what Kuljin and Moffitt's model suggest? So just it's an extension of the Baer strain theory, which confirms the some points related to the stability of the cyclopropane and cyclopentane, which was proposed by the Baer. What Baer has proposed, he said that the cyclopropane and cyclobutane, these are the least stable molecules which are having more angle strain. If the angle strain is more, then the stability of such a compounds is less. So same things can be confirmed by this Kuljin and Moffitt's modification. So Baer was unable to answer the question how it is possible in the cyclopropane, and for that purpose Kuljin has and Moffitt's, they have proposed the concept of the bent bond, how it was possible for cyclohexane to maintain the bond angle to the 60 degree. So bent bonds are a special type of a chemical bonding in which ordinary hybridization state of two atoms making up a chemical bond are modified. As I said, that there is an increase or decrease in the s orbital characteristics takes place to get the proper bond angle in order to accommodate a particular molecular geometry. So in bent bond, these are the special type of bond which in which whatever the two atoms that are involved, there the s character either increased or decreased to maintain the proper geometry, to maintain the particular bond angle. So what they has proposed, bent bonds are found in strained organic compounds such as cyclopropane, oxyrenes or aziridines. Along with the cyclopropane, other heterocyclic compounds are there in which also these bent bonds are present. In these compounds, it is not possible for carbon atoms to assume the 109.5 bond angle, which is having a standard sp3 hybridization. So in such a type of the molecules, it is not possible for a carbon atom to maintain the tetrahedral geometry, and due to which bond angle is maintained at the it is not possible to maintain the bond angle at 109.5. So in this case, what happens, the increasing the p character of sp, means if sp3 hybridization there, sp2 hybridization is there, then here due to increase in the p character of the sp, for example hybridization state, that is the 1,6 is the s character density and 5/6 is the p character density, makes it is possible to reduce the bond angle to the 60 degree. Means instead of the sp2 hybridized state, sp3 hybridized state of that particular carbon atom, here the s character of that particular carbon atom is modified. So in cyclopropane, this molecule is having a density of the 1s to 6, while the p orbital is having a density of 5s to 6. At the same time, carbon to hydrogen bond gains more s character, which shortens. Then in cyclopropane, the maximum electron density between two carbon atoms does not correspond to the internuclear axis, hence the name bent bond is given. In cyclopropane, the in-orbital angle is 104. This bending can be observed experimentally by X-ray diffraction of certain cyclopropane derivatives. Means whatever the Kuljin and Moffitt's theory or modification says, that can be
confirmed with the help of the X-ray diffraction study, where X-ray diffraction study is used to know the what is the bond length, bond angle, and what is the position of the different atoms in the given molecule. So according to Kaljan and Moffitt, the whatever the bonds that are present in the cyclopropane are there, they are bent to order in order to achieve the particular geometry, and also there is a change in the S character, means whatever the S and P characters are present in that particular cyclopropane, out of that 1/6 is S character and 5/6 is P character. So this bending can be observed experimentally with the help of the X-ray diffraction study, where the deformation density is outside the line of the center between the carbon atoms. So the carbon-carbon bond lengths are also shorter than regular alkane bond, that is the 151 versus the 153 picometers. So in the regular alkanes, the bond length between carbon-carbon atoms is 153 picometer, while in case of the cyclopropane, it was observed 151 picometer. So this is the change in the bond length of that particular carbon-carbon bond length is also observed. So this also confirms that they are behaving different as compared to the alkanes. Their nature is different as compared to the alkanes chemically. Also, cyclobutane, if we consider in case of cyclobutane, cyclobutane is a larger ring as compared to the cyclopropane, but still it has a bent bond. In this molecule, the carbon bond angles are 90 degree for the planar conformations, while 88 degree for the Packard one. Packard means what? Here, some of the carbon atoms will go outside the plane to adjust the, to gain the more stability, they will go into the out of plane, and due to which these types of the structures are known as the Packard structure. Unlike in cyclopropane, the carbon-carbon bond lengths actually increase rather than decrease. This is mainly due to the 1,3 non-bonded steric repulsion. Now, according to the X-ray diffraction study of cyclobutane, it was observed that the carbon-carbon bond lengths are actually more as compared to the alkanes. While in case of cyclopropane, we have seen that the bond lengths are decreased, while in case of the cyclobutane, the bond lengths are increased. And what is the reason behind this? It is due to the 1,3 non-bonded steric repulsion. So whatever the carbon atom or hydrogen atom that are present at the first and three, they are coming closer towards each other. Whatever the hydrogen atoms are there, they are coming closer towards the each other. And as we know, if the like atoms comes closer towards each other, there will be the repulsion between these particular atoms. And this is the reason why the carbon-carbon bond lengths are actually increased in case of cyclobutane as compared to the carbon-carbon that is present, bond length that is present in the alkanes. In terms of the reactivity, cyclobutane is relatively inert and behaves like ordinary alkane. So cyclopropane, as we know, they are more reactive as compared to the cyclobutane, and cyclobutane is relatively inert and behave like an ordinary alkanes. The bent bond theory can also explain the other phenomena in the organic molecules. In fluoromethane, for instance, the experimental fluorine carbon hydrogen bond angle is 109, which is greater than the calculated value. Means whatever the other organic molecules are there, they are also possessing the bent bond in order to get the proper geometry. This can be explained by the Kaljan-Moffitt theory also. So not only cycloalkanes or the cyclic compounds are possessing this bent bond, but some other organic compounds are also possessing, like fluoromethane, in which these bent bonds are present, and in such a compounds the bond angle is 109, which is greater as compared to the calculated value. So this is about the Kaljan-Moffitt modification. Now this is because according to the Bend's rule, the carbon fluorine bond gains p orbital character, leading to the highest character in the CH bonds, and due to which HCH bond angle approaching those sp2 orbitals, example 120 degree, leaving less for the fluorine, carbon and H bond angle. And this is the reason why the fluorine carbon hydrogen bond is more as compared to the calculated value. This difference is again explained in terms of the bend bond. Bend bonds also come into play in the gauge effect, explaining the preference of gauge conformations in certain substituted alkenes and the alkene cis effect associated with some unusually stable alkene cis isomers. So these are the various examples actually in which also whatever the variation in the bond angle is observed, that bond angle variation can be explained with help of the Kolgin-Moffitt's modification. So this is about the Kolgin-Moffitt's modification. Next theory that we are going to discuss is Sachse-Mohr theory, where it is particularly explains the stability and reactivity of cyclohexane. As we know, one of the limitation for the Baer's strength theory was, according to the Baer, the whatever the cyclohexane molecules are there, these cyclohexane molecules are unstable and they does not exist due to the negative strength. But actually, practically, these cyclohexane molecules as well as the higher molecules are existing and they are quite stable as compared to the other compounds like cyclopropane, cyclobutane and cyclopentane. So this theory exclusively explains why cyclohexane molecules and other higher molecules are stable. So that's why this theory is also known as the theory of strainless rings. Sachse-Mohr theory was proposed to explain the reason behind the stability of higher cyclohexane and the other higher alkanes. According to this theory, carbon atoms in 3 to 5 membered rings lie in the same plane, whereas the carbon atoms in a 6 membered ring or the higher membered ring do not lie in the same plane, although they lie in the different plane. So what Baer has assumed that whatever the carbon atoms that are present in the cyclohexane molecule, these are lying the other compounds, that is the cyclopropane, they are lying in the one plane. Also he has proposed that whatever the carbon atoms that are present in the cycloalkanes, they are lying in the one plane. But according to this theory, the whatever the cycloalkanes that are having 3 to 5 membered ring, in that the cycloalkanes, these compounds are having carbon atom in the one plane, but for a 6 membered ring or the higher rings, they are having in the different plane. As the carbon atoms present in the 6 membered ring and higher ring lie in the different planes, there is no alteration in the normal tetrahedral angle. And that's why for 6 membered ring and higher membered ring, it is easy for them to maintain the bond angle to 109 degree, and that's why they maintain the tetrahedral geometry. And therefore, there is no any angle strain in the bigger rings and they are stable. Means, as there is no any angle strain present between the larger molecules, these particular rings are more stable. For example, chair and boat forms are two strainless rings of cyclohexane which are interconvertible into each other. This can be seen by this particular diagram. Here you can see also in conformation of cyclohexane, we have seen which are the different conformation. Just here we will be discussing chair conformation and boat conformation. Here you can see, just I have depicted over here the chair conformation, which gives us information related to the two types of the hydrogens that are present in the cyclohexane. One is the axial. So all these hydrogen atoms are known as the axial. As we know, each carbon atom present in the cyclohexane is having two hydrogen atoms. Out of that, one is present in the axial position, other one is present in the equatorial position. Here, this diagram only indicates the axial hydrogens. This diagram only indicates the equatorial hydrogens, while this diagram togetherly shows both axial as well as the equatorial hydrogen. So here, in this way, as you see, all these particular carbon atoms are not lying in the one plane, and due to which it is very easy for these particular carbon atoms, for example, this carbon atom and this carbon atom, to maintain the tetrahedral geometry. Also, if we convert the chair conformation, this is the chair conformation which looks like a chair, this is the boat conformation which looks like the boat. So we can convert this chair conformation into boat conformation easily. In that case, whatever the hydrogen atoms that are present in the axial position, they are becoming equatorial in the boat conformation, or vice versa. In this way, these conformations can be altered, and due to this, the carbon atoms, as they are lying in the different plane, it is easy for such a compounds to maintain the tetrahedral geometry. Sykes-Mohr theory of stainless rings was further supported and explained by Mohr in 1918 to cover the compounds that are containing the two rings fused together. The bigger sized rings are rather difficult to synthesize, even though there is no angle strain in them. This is primarily due to the fact that two ends of the chain of atoms must come close together for ring closure to take place. If the chain which is involved in the ring closure is long, there is a possibility of minimum chances that the two rings come closer to form the ring. So, whatever the chains, they are having two fused rings. If though there is no any angle strain is present, they are difficult to synthesize, because the fact that two ends of the chain of atoms must come close towards the ring to closure to take place. And if the chain is involved in the ring closure is long, then there is a possibility that minimum chances that the two rings come closer to form the ring. But when such rings are formed, they are quite stable. So this also explains that the higher rings does not have any strain, because it is in that case the carbon atoms that are present, they are present in the out of plane. So this is about the Kolmogorov-Schmidt modification, as well as the Sykes-Mohr theory, which explains the phenomenon of the strainless ring. So here we have completed the theories that are associated with the stability and the reactivity of cycloalkenes. So if you have any queries related to the pharmaceutical organic chemistry, then you can contact me on this particular mail ID. And if you like the content of this video, please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.